When smoke gets blown into the Lake Tahoe region, it's not just in the air, it's in the water too, affecting the lake's clarity and quality. A study of the smoke's impacts began on Saturday when a crew of researchers deployed this robotic glider, which will gather data as it moves beneath the water's surface over the next 4 weeks. The glider will float along a GPS-guided course, moving east to west and then north to south, gathering information on the water and its ecosystem as smoke conditions change. The hope is to understand how quickly the lake water can bounce back to its pre-fire condition. This same study was run towards the end of the Caldor fire last year, led by Dr. Alex Forrest with the UC Davis Tahoe Environmental Research Center. Then Forrest and his team were expecting that recovery process to take about 6 months, but the actual recovery time surprised them.
Cleared much quicker than we were expecting. So the lake has sort of natural mechanisms to clear these particles out of suspension in the water column.
It took about 3 to 4 weeks for Lake Tahoe's microbiome to clear out the pollution and particles and excess nitrogen brought in by the smoke. But in this case, scientists had started to gather data as smoke conditions from the Caldor fire were already improving. With the Mosquito fire this year, they launched the glider before the smoke had arrived in the Lake Basin. So they're hoping to confirm their optimistic findings from last year. Dr. Jeff Schlatto is the director of the UC Davis Tahoe Environmental Research Center. He says data like this can give important insights for lakes throughout the western U.S. as the risks for large wildfires continues to increase.
This may be the new normal. And so with those particles, with those nutrients coming into all of these water bodies, how are they all going to change? How is that going to change the quality of drinking water?
And again, the glider will be in the water for the next several weeks, moving continuously at about a half mile each hour. It's only going to surface once every day to get new GPS coordinates. So if you're in the area, you likely won't see it in action. The glider also uses an extremely efficient propulsion system, making this study very clean and very quiet. I'm meteorologist Heather Waldman for KCRA 3 News.